See. Okay. Well, wow. This book is $150? Hey, Ross, where my money makes money, going broke for college. Now, a lot of you have a lot of student debt from those loans that you took. Now, a lot of us are very materialistic and not in a closed manner. We're very, very bougie when it comes to college. We want to go to these high-paying schools where a semester or even a year is $50,000. $50,000. So if you do 4 years at $50,000, that's $200,000 in student loan, in school debt. Why? We want to go to these prestigious colleges for a piece of paper that's saying, hey man, you're smart. You did it. You graduated high school and now you graduated college. But guess what? You have $200,000 that you need to pay back. And majority of us, the majority, we get out making what? $45,000, $50,000, sometimes $60,000. And if you're lucky, $80,000 to $100,000. But most people are kind of really in that $40,000 to $55,000 category. And you have a $200,000 student debt. Now, you still have to live, so you have an apartment or a house or a condo or a trailer or some sort of living quarters. Then most of us, we want a car, then you have that. Then you have insurance and renter's insurance. Then most of us have a cell phone. What am I getting at? Going broke for college. Now, you're going broke for college over a name. Because a lot of these colleges that cost that amount of money, $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 a semester or even a year, their books are expensive too. Their books are expensive too. $150 a book for you to take a class for a couple of weeks. Now, some of you, I'm going to keep my book, so it's going to pay for itself over the course of time. You have a point. Some of that information will never change, but if any of you ever been to high school or college, you get that book, and it's the what edition? The third edition, the fourth edition, the fifth edition, the sixth edition, the seventh edition. That means, guess what? They come out with a different edition every summer, every winter, every year. This is the thing, guys. We're spending all this money going to college. So this is how you do it, right? This is how you do it. Now, this is how you do it. If you're able to, okay, you can clip your classes. That means you get a book. You read up on it, you study up on it, and then you test out that class. Now, some of you are saying, well, I'm really not that good without a teacher or professor or an instructor to assist me along the way. And I totally understand that. Some of us need that extra help, that extra support, asking questions, getting feedback, so on and so forth. I understand that. So for those who can't do it, maybe that's not a good thing because you don't want to fail it, then you just wasted some money. But for some of you who can really work on your own, see what type of degree you want and go and clap some classes to get those college credits. Then for the other ones of you, now there are some courses out there that you can take independently of a college that can transfer into college credits. But I would advise going to a community college, for the first 2 years where you're going to still obtain your associate's degree at a lower cost, and you're already halfway done to your bachelor's, okay? To your bachelor's, because I have an associate's, a bachelor's, and a master's degree. Now, this is what I did, okay? I needed something, man, mine was a little bit different. I needed goals for myself. I needed goals. Going to a four-year college, straight off the bat, I like, well, if I go here at the community college, I can get an associate's degree. My milestone, then another 2 years, my bachelor's degree, another milestone, then another 2 years, my master's degree, another milestone, and I'm actually thinking about getting my PhD. It's a lot of damn writing, dissertations and all this bullcrap. But you have to do what's best for you. Now, some of you, I got it. You want to go to all these universities, Florida State, Tennessee State, Washington State, and universities, Florida A&M, I don't know, you know, there's a hundred of thousands of colleges in the United States of America. It's a lot of colleges. There's no way I can name them all. But the point is, how about save yourself a little bit of money? How about save yourself a little bit of money? Now, for some of you, I'm not really advertising this, but you can go to the military and they'll pay for your college for free. That's an option. Sometimes if you read the laws in your state, if your immediate family member, like your mom or dad, was in the military, you can actually go to school for free. That's an option. Also, within your state, community colleges, some classes are free. Sometimes maybe the college even for free, or maybe the first year is for free. Do your research before you just go out here and apply for all these loans. And most importantly, apply for scholarships if you don't even qualify or think you qualify. If you say, hey, write an essay or do a community project or pick up trash, do it and record it and send it in, whatever the criteria is. First and foremost, we are human and human makes mistakes. Maybe somebody mistakenly give you $50,000 for you to get your college degree. We don't know. Stop accruing debt with these student loans, because a lot of you people are what? $60,000, $65,000 in student debt. And you're trying to get your first job or your second job, and you're trying to put that student loan in what? Deferment, so you don't have to pay it. You don't have to pay it right now. We hold off. Then we get so goddamn old, we're like, man, I got to pay the student loan. Now, the interest rate are sometimes what? 0 to 1 to 2%. Now, granted, if it's 0%, actually good for you, but nevertheless, you have a debt that you need to pay off. And guess what? If you don't pay off your debt, they're going to take your taxes. If you don't pay off your debt, they're going to take your tax refund. They're going to take it. You'll never see it again. And the reason why I say that, how long do you think it's going to take you to pay off that debt? Let's say, for instance, $60,000, and you only receive $5,000 or $6,000. Now, we'll make it an even number. If you got $10,000 because you're a family, you got two or three kids, your wife, and your husband, it's going to take you 6 years at 0% to pay off that with your tax return, So that's saying almost a decade, all the money you paid to the government, you're not going to receive it. You're not going to receive it because you accumulated so much student debt from taking out all those loans to pay for all that education that you're only making $40,000 or $50,000 for. You're only making $40,000 or $50,000. And quite frankly, you might be even living paycheck to paycheck trying to figure out how the hell I'm going to pay this student loan that I don't even operate in, that I don't even use. Now, you went to school for a marine biologist, but you're a secretary at a business. You went to school to be a lawyer, but you're interim and a paralegal for your third year, which could actually help you, you know, pass your bar exam, et cetera, et cetera. I'm just trying to give examples here, and don't really quote me in all the details because I don't know the procedures that a paralegal or someone in law school goes through to actually get their law license. But the point I'm making here is we pay entirely too much for college. We absolutely do. Now, some of us do it because of tradition, because our parents went there, our grandparents went there. That doesn't mean it's a good choice for you. Now, it may be a phenomenal school, and it may have a great rate of you getting a great job when you get out. But my point is this. At the end of the day, you got to pay that damn bill. Now, for those of you with that scholarship that funds you 100%, this doesn't apply. Go to a school who gives you that 100% scholarship. Now, I know people who got scholarships who did not go to that school. They actually went to a school that gave them a partial scholarship because of the name, because of the location. Let's not be stupid, guys. But listen, at the end of the day, it's your choice. If you want to go to a school and accumulate debt and you have a scholarship somewhere else, that's stupid, in my opinion. But if you want to go to a four-year school that costs $40,000 to $50,000 a year or even a semester, in my opinion, that's really fucking stupid. Why not just hit up a community college? Get that associate's degree. Take that associate's degree and find a college prior to. Now, do your research prior to you going to that community college. Now, before you just go out and enroll to any community college, I would advise that you do your research on that college. Make sure those college credits transfer to the four-year school that you want to go to. And I want to note this again, scholarships, grants. I'm gonna say it again, scholarships and grants. Apply for them even if you do not qualify. Do it. Sometimes they just give you money. Back again, make sure those college credits at the community college transfer over to your four-year college. And I know there's a lot of factors about what school you want to attend. I'm not just telling you to go out here and enroll to any cheap four-year college, okay? But make sure they have your major, all the materials, they have good labs, and all those things for you to be successful once you graduate. But let's be smart about these degrees. You don't need to be in a four-year school that costs this astronomical price where you have a community college right down the road for a tenth or even a quarter of the price that's going to save you $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, $80,000 if you just went to the four-year school up the street. Go to your community college. Look for those grants, financial aid, scholarships, etc. to help you lower the cost of the student debt you will be incurring when you hit that four-year college. But that four-year college is now what? A two-year college. And 9 times out of 10, a lot of you guys gonna already have your associate's degree. And when I got my associate's degree, I wanted more. I felt good. I saw my name on a piece of paper. I'm like, man, I obtained something. But now I want the next milestone in my life. Some of you are saying, well, I'm not going to no four-year college. Well, go to an institute of some sort, okay? To gather and learn and train all those skills that's going to help you, then do so. Just go to damn school and get your education so you can either be an entrepreneur, make up your own business, or have the skills to go out and get a job that's going to help you. And note, I want all of you guys to do wonderful in life, but don't just accumulate debt simply because a name of a school. There's other factors, there's other details you really need to consider. And don't forget the options I said, okay? Don't forget the options. Financial aid, grants, scholarships, also clipping, okay? All these options are here for you to lower the cost of your education and still get your name on a piece of paper and saying, hey, I went to school and now I'm smarter than you. Because a lot of people think that particular thing, but I'll tell you what college does. College diversifies, ding, 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 your mind. It makes you read stuff you have never read. It helps you to obtain a vast vocabulary of words. So when people are talking to you, you now understand what the hell they're talking about. Have you ever been talking with someone and they said a word you did not mean, like vicissitude? And you're like, what the hell does vicissitude mean? And they're like, it means fate. And you're wondering, why didn't you just say fate? Because their vocabulary is a lot larger than yours and their mind doesn't really operate on a minuscule scale. Duh. So go to school, go to your institutes, get those skills, get that knowledge, but just don't pay a lot of damn money for it. This Ross world where we are smart even about the school we go to. I'm out.